Hi, I'm going to do a tutorial today showing you how to create styles in Word. Styles is a function in Word on the home tab of the ribbon. If you are creating a document with several headings with different formatting, this function is super useful. You can use the existing settings that are set within Word, or you can create a style completely from scratch and/or modify an existing style. If you look in the top right corner, you will see a card that is a link to a tutorial showing you how to modify headings or styles that are existing. For this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create your own styles in Word from scratch. Each style has its own formatting. You may have a document that you are creating and the existing styles in Word may not suit the formatting that you prefer. Generally, what I do when I create a style is I add my initials to the new style so that when I see the styles listed in Word, I can quickly see which ones are my own custom styles. Let's go to Word now and I'll show you how to create your own styles. I've made a numbered list here so that I don't get off track. It's easy to do that. There's so many ways to do things in Word and it always seems to lead into things that are not part of the tutorial. So basically, I want to first tell you that these are the styles up here. This is the style box. And if you click on this, you can see all the available styles that are within Word. Now, if I click on here, you'll see watch down here. You'll see that everything will start changing to be what these styles are set at. And you may not like the formatting of the styles that are set. Your document you may like something different. So that's basically what this is up here is styles. So basically what you want to do is when you're going to create a style is you are going to use the quick keys and or you could use the mouse, but it's in the home tab. I just use the alt key and you'll see my quick key tiles have appeared. H is for home and then L is over there on the bottom right of styles right over here. See that? And of course this is much faster when you are using your quick keys without talking and describing things. So you'll see I've now got a drop down box with create a style, clear formatting and apply styles. So I'm going to say create a style. And now I get this new style from formatting box and this is where you get to give it a name. And I had previously said I use my initials. So I'm going to call this CPJ Heading 1 and I'm going to say shading because I'm going to choose shading for my formatting for this style. And so now what you want to do is you want to modify this the formatting. So you'll see the modify box down here. To get into that, I use my alt key and the underlined letter, which is M, and I now get this dialog box. And this is where it tells you the properties of the style. It's CPJ Heading 1 shading. That will appear here when once I'm done, and I'll talk about that in a few minutes. And the style type, it's a linked paragraph and character. And if you click over here, you can choose whether it's paragraph, a character, a table, or a list. We're going to leave it at linked paragraph and character. You can play around with those things yourself. I'm not going to get into that for this tutorial because I want to keep it kind of short here. The style is based on, if you click on that, you can say that it is based on, I want to say normal because I do want it to have space and the no space style. I just don't want to base it on that. I want to base it on normal. So you see up here it was in no space, so I changed it to be normal because whatever it is clicked on here will be whatever shows up in here. And what that means is that if you liked some of the formatting in any of these styles here, you could base it on that and then do your own custom things as well. So I'm going to keep it at normal. And then what I want to do is down here, you'll see that it says add to the styles gallery. I want to make sure that that's clicked on because I want to see that up in my document here when I'm working throughout my document so that I can choose the formatting that I am going to customize right now. And you also want to choose automatically update. And what that means is that anytime that I make changes to this heading, let's say I hand it in to my supervisor and they want to make some more changes to the formatting of the header, I just have to go to one of those headings, make those changes, and it will change for all of the headings. And then here it says only in this document, new documents based on this template. What that means is that I want CPJ heading one shading to only be in styles for this document, or if I want it to be anytime I open up a new document from this point forward, I would check there. And then at the end of the day, when I turn off my computer, I will be prompted again to say, it will say, do you want to, changes were made to the global template. Do you want to save those changes? It'll either say global or normal. And if you did remember making changes, you want to say yes at that point so that when you turn your computer back on, you're going to have all of these headings, CPJ heading one shading, you'll have it for the next day in your documents. So if you just want it for this document and no other documents, then you would choose that. And I'm going to keep it at that just because I'm doing a tutorial and this is probably not going to be a style that I'm going to use regularly. So if you click on format, you'll see that we get a bunch of options here to go into. So I'm going to click into font first. And for this heading, I'm going to choose small caps. Small caps is an all cap letter. The first letter of any word in a heading, and then the rest of the letters will be in capital letters, but a little bit smaller than that first letter. You could have all caps, you could have strike through, double strike through, superscript, or subscript. And here is where you pick your font. You can scroll down and pick what you want. I'm going to stick with Arial, and I want it to be bold. And I'm going to choose that my font size for my headings be at 14, a little bit bigger than what my body text is. So then that's all set and I say okay, and then I go back into format, I've done font, then I go to paragraph. I'm going to say I want it to be aligned left. I want a before of 18, and that's the space before my heading. I want it to be at 18, and I'll show you what that means in a minute when we go through, you'll see. And the space after is set at 12, which is the space in between these two paragraphs. So the space before for a heading is the space from here to here, and that's what I want at 18. I want my heading to, if I had some paragraphs, let's say I put a heading here, I want to have a little bit more space, sort of differentiating the context within that heading, the text that it's for a certain topic. And if you are not getting space in between your paragraphs, chances are that this is clicked on. You'll see that it says don't add space between the paragraphs of the same style. Then no space would turn would be put between the paragraphs, between your two paragraphs here. So if you're making changes to your paragraph formatting and the spacing and it's not changing, chances are that is checked on. Come in and check it off. And then here, the line spacing. If my document was 1.5 spacing, I would want this to be at 1.5 spacing. If it was single, I would want it to be at single and all the way down, absolutely. You could do at least, you could set a number value here, you could say exactly a number value you could put here, or multiple. But for now, I'm going to keep it at single, but just so you know, that's what that is. Okay, so then also you can set tabs here, or you can set them in tabs at the format thing. And I'm going to go back and set them there just so that you can see what I mean. It seems like there's always more than one way to set things up in Word. So you can always check when you're in a dialog box, you may be able to kill two birds with one stone, so to speak, because you could do the tabs here instead of going where I'm going to go right now. So we go back into format, and tabs was the next thing. And so here we can set our tabs. And I'm gonna actually just clear all the tabs right now because I don't think that I want any tabs within, well, actually I'm gonna do a 0.5 because I just thought of something that I was gonna do. So I'm just gonna put back a 0.5. So I do 0.5 and then set and okay, go back to format and then borders. I do want to, normally this would be here, but I was in shading a few moments ago. So I could have a border around my heading, which I don't think that would be appropriate. What I wanted to do was have shading for my heading. And so you can choose to have a color for your shading, or you can choose to have it as, if you click here, it's at clear right now. I know personally that 15% is perfect. It's not too light. It's dark enough that it kind of sets itself out. So I'm going to choose that. And here I could change my coloring from gray. It said automatic is part of gray because it's 15% of black. Or I could choose another color just by clicking in here. So if you want a color document, that is where you would change the color for it. So we'll go back here, format. So we did borders. You can change the language. You can change the frame, and you just click into these things and change them here. Okay, so the frame is actually a frame around the heading, and I don't want that either. And numbering. So I do want to choose some numbering. So if I go into here, I would maybe like to have my first heading. You may have headings like this, and then the next would be this, and then the next would be this. So my heading number one, CPJ heading number one, I'm going to use this numbering. And you can actually define your new number format in here, but I'm just going to click OK for now. And then you can also make a shortcut key to call up these this style by clicking on here. And let's say that I did Alt N. If whatever keystrokes that you use for a shortcut key, you definitely want to look here and see, are those keys assigned to anything? It's currently assigned to unassigned. So I could use that. I would say assign if I wanted to do that. And it would be assigned to that heading. And all I would have to do wherever I wanted to make that heading is do a return and use the Alt N keys. But I'm not going to do that right now. But you could do that if you want to. And then text effects is exactly like it says. If you click in, you can do some text fill and some text outline. I'm not going to do that either. Okay, so now I'm going to click OK. And you'll see that now I have a heading up here that says create style. And it actually changed all my numbering here, and that's okay. I don't mind that it's done that because I'm just going to delete this anyways because I went through all of that. And I don't remember actually if I said add styles to the gallery, but that was an option. If you go back and look at the very bottom of the template, yeah, I did. I remember now because I told you about the template and asked you at the end of the day. Okay, so let's pretend that I want to have another heading here. Maybe the context is different. So now all I have to do is I'll use the Alt key, home, go up here, and then I pick, can you see I'm using the arrow keys, and I want to pick CPJ heading, and I go here, and I say, this is another style heading for CPJ. I'm just gonna use whatever wording. And then if I wanted to go here, I do the same again, and you'll see, say HL, and pick there. And let's just go in here, and you'll see that we have that 18 before and the 12 after, and so if everything is fine, then you just would leave it like that. But if you notice that maybe you didn't like the 18 points here, then you could modify that style. And I told you that I had a separate tutorial on how to modify a style, and the card was at the beginning of this tutorial. So if you want to go into that tutorial, you can learn how you can modify an existing style. Maybe your supervisor has handed it back to you and said, I don't really like the way that this is done. One of the things I noticed is that the numbering is not bolded. So you would definitely want to go up here into modify, define that new number format, go into font and say you want it bolded. And once you say okay, it says changing the number format updates the style shading and reapplies the style. Do you want to continue? I'm going to say yes, because it's all bolded anyways. So that's fine. And now my numbers are bolded as well. Okay. So hopefully I've helped you and you now know how to create new styles in Word. Good luck. I personally love Windows 10 and I think that the issues we have are usually always user related. Have a fantastic day. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. There should be an icon on the bottom right corner for you to do that.